Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to round seven of the Core Australian V8 Supercars Championship. It's me, Tom Chorley, here once again this evening. Not joined by Adam Weller this time, though. Adam is unavailable this evening. Luckily, we've got someone just as good to come along and help us out in the form of Mr. Johnny B. Johnny, how are you this evening?
I'm very good, thanks, Chorley. And yourself?
Yes, excellent, mate, as we've hopefully got a great series of races going on today. This time, coming from the Grand Valley East Circuit, only the second time in the series we've been to one of the Gran Turismo-based racetracks rather than the real-world affairs we've recently gotten used to. Let's jump into the action then, and whilst we wait for this, we'll fill you in on the grid for today's race. It's Memso 89 in pole position once again in the Camaro, joined on the front row by Killing Heidi, who was but 0.066 of a second away from that coveted top slot himself. So it's a great job from Heidi today, and the whole grid covered by just 0.4 of a second. We may only be having six cars out there, but it's going to be one close affair between them all as we wait for the magical five lights to come on, and then we're going to be racing here. It's quite a short circuit, but who's going to get the jump when the lights eventually go out? Cherry red Camaro on the left, the bronze coloured Mercedes, it's the Lexus on the right, the Mustang of its racing behind Memso. As we wait for the action now, oh, we can even see them. We've got two, we've got three, four, five lights, and here it is, go. And it looks like a decent start from Memso, even with a fair bit of wheel spin there. It's racing as challenging Killing Heidi there for second place. It looks like he's got it in front there.
He's done it, yeah.
Yeah, it's a good start there from Mitz Racing. Memso holds the lead into the first left-hander. And we see, he's running it a bit wide there, but he looks to have held on to it as Killing Heidi looks to at least hold on to third position. Glenhouse in fourth position there ahead of Evil Dragon and Santu bringing up the field at the moment as they make their way in the underpass. It's Larry stuff as early on here as we've come to used to from these Aussie V8s. And we should be quite a close affair after such a close qualifying session. What do you make of it so far then, Johnny?
Well, it's thrilling stuff, and certainly Killing Heidi looks determined to get his second place back as it's a fantastic jump on him at the start. Also down in fourth and fifth. Oh, we got a bit of contact in the barrier there as that looks like Glenn Owls' Mercedes run into the wall.
Yeah, Glenn didn't look to have the best of starts and now is giving himself even more work. I don't think he's sustained any damage while it looks on there, but he's certainly giving himself more work to do now as he's shuffled his way to the back of the grid. As the top three look to have made a bit of a jump now and put up a bit of a gap between themselves and Evil Dragon in fourth position. There's dust getting kicked up there by, I think it was Killing Heidi going into turn one, who has annexed himself onto the back of that other green Mustang as he clearly wants that second position back to challenge for the lead eventually later on. But Memso still holding it out front as we wait for the action to come to us on this one. Cherry red Mustang then leading away quite nicely at the moment, and Evil Dragon sustaining the form we saw a bit from him at the Nürburgring. Of course, it was all a bit of a messy affair there. You may have noticed we haven't got Optimus Prime with us this evening, as unfortunately the American didn't take too kindly to the results the stewards handed him after the end of the third race at the Nürburgring. I remember commentating on the time that we weren't particularly impressed with the driving standards of that race, and the stewards rather agreed with us on that one and handed out some pretty hefty penalties, didn't they?
They certainly did, as we follow the action again, jumping back to the back of the grid even, as yes, it looks like Dan Owls is well and truly determined to make up for earlier mistakes and is right on the back of the other Mercedes. Certainly, yes, a thrilling race that we've got developing here at the front of the field and indeed at the back, with its racing certainly keeping Memso in check at the moment, it would seem.
Yeah, we seem to have a bit of a spread going on at the moment. The two Mercedes duelling away, unfortunately, for last position, or rather the right to not be last position in this case. Evil Dragon has gapped them a wee little bit. And as we say, though, those top three are edging away, although things look to have sprung out just a little bit between those three. But it's multiple laps we've got going here, 17 today. It's a reasonably short circuit, this one. An old Gran Turismo favourite, perhaps, is the regular version of this, which is the much longer version, some 3-odd miles in length. This is the much shorter version, one we've never really used before in core racing. It's a good turn up to the books to see us come somewhere a little bit different for a change. Have you ever particularly rated this track, Johnny, at all?
I will admit I tended to dismiss it. As you said, generally, if the option's there, you'd go for the larger of the circuits. But having sort of thought about it for a little while, this circuit does take out some of the sort of more, prolonged, sustained corners that really do sort of, while they're fun to drive in solo, do kill the racing a little bit. So perhaps this is the hidden gem of the Grand Valley tracks.
Yeah, I'd agree with you on that one, because in the big circuit you've got that long swoopy sector one where it's all fast corners going up and down through the hills, but you're right, it does tend to spread out the racing a little bit as you've got a lot of stop start action going on through quite long radius corners, which does have that tendency, as you say, to sprung it out a little bit. So at the moment though, Memso looks to have got on the job with this one, maybe smoking a lot out of the back of that Camaro, but it doesn't seem to be slowing him down a lot, as is its racer, who still hasn't been able to shake off the rather bronze-coloured, I think it's the Mercedes of Killing Heidi behind him. So things, yes, it is the other Mercedes. Killing Heidi, clearly not just a one-hit wonder in qualifying on this occasion. He's obviously dialed himself into this racetrack and is enjoying it quite a lot at the moment, and hanging on quite nicely to its racing there. Difficult to see too many overtaking places though, John. It's almost as if in going for the shorter version you've lopped off all the major overtaking routes.
Yes, they've sort of, well, they've got what is turn one on the normal forward circuit, so they've got that hairpin, which I imagine provides some opportunity, although as you said it does have those fast S's just before it, so getting the run is definitely going to be a difficult thing to do. But I imagine in these cars, with their sort of lower amount of aero, it's easier than, say, in prototypes which frequently race in core. But certainly, it does seem as though Killing Heidi is struggling to find an opportunity to get around that bright green Mustang.
Yeah, as I say, in the normal direction the circuit flows, you get quite a fast run onto the start-finish straight, which in itself is quite long and does normally provide an opportunity into T1, which in this case is actually the final corner. And yeah, it seems to be in reverse. It's not offering up too many chances at the moment, but there's still time to go on. And we normally see the first race can be a little bit processional as everyone finds their feet a little bit, and then fireworks go off for race two and three once people start getting a little overconfident. But Glenn has off screen managed to work his way past Santu now into an ultimate position, eyeing up Evil Dragon next, who looks to be a good couple of seconds in front of him though, so he's got a bit of work to do before he catches up with Dragon to challenge that fourth position, and then see if he can get on terms with these top three. As I say, they're still spreading out a little bit now. Killing Heidi not quite crawling all over its racing as he was not long ago then, so but it certainly looks like, as we see a big accident there for Glenn, who's dropped it on the curves going into the tunnel. Oh, he's been hit there. That's not what we wanted to see. But Glenn dropping it on the curves, as we saw there, and pointing it into the wall, and perhaps in the dark, unsighted, has been collected there. So, there's rather uncharacteristic mistake going on here from Glenn. It's not what we normally see from him.
Yeah, he was certainly during the Nürburgring 24 hours earlier in the year, he was really one of the most consistent drivers out there. So, yeah, a bit surprising really, especially since it's not really a place that you tend to go off, just because those kerbs, while they are quite large, there's a fairly flat area on the top of them that means you can sort of, the car rests on it rather than sort of skidding over it. So who really knows? We are hearing from race control though that Santu did manage to get cleanly by, so Glenn wasn't actually hit the second time. So yeah, just an uncharacteristic error really.
A trick of our camera, unfortunately. My mistake there. But either way, it's done more damage. Oh, as we see, Glenn is now back in front of Santu. So I think perhaps the Indian driver's had his own little adventure out there somewhere and let Glenn back past him. Either that, or he felt too... not very bad for him in letting through out of kindness, which I suspect it probably isn't the case. Racing drivers aren't renowned for kindness of that scale. So anyway, let's run back over the top six positions. Memso still leading quite happily, edging away slowly by slowly, lap on lap, although last time round he took added 6 tenths to his lead over its racing. So Memso looks to be dialed into this place, but as we saw at Brands Hatch when we thought he was dialed in quite nicely there, he ended up making mistakes which then ruined the rest of his afternoon. So whilst things may look a bit serene in the lead there for him, we shouldn't count our chickens yet, as he is capable of springing unpleasant surprises on us. So we'll have to see how this one develops. Its racing looks fairly consistent though, as we've seen all season really, even the Mustangs, apart from that rather scrappy race there in Monza. But yeah, it's Glenn's consistency now behind Santu once again. I don't know if you could see what's going on back there, as it's certainly it's the most exciting action we've got going on track at the moment, unfortunately. But yeah, Glenn's early consistency seems to have abandoned him, and now he's sort of progressively making more mistakes, which has started to cost him valuable championship points really, when early season it was his consistency and his ability to pounce on people's mistakes which was his real strength really, that was, oh god, yeah, as we see, there's damage definitely on the Mercedes, and unfortunately a disconnection there for Glenn, which might explain a few of his incidents actually, if he was having connection issues. So bad luck for Glenn there, and that's really put a dent in any championship chance he's now got, as yeah, can't pick up any points if you don't finish, unfortunately. So that's going to give Santu a rather lonely distinction of last place now. So, as we're nearing the end, after 7 rounds in the championship, John, who do you think has showed the promise at the moment? Memso, when he's actually on track, has shown a good turn of pace most of the time, even if it occasionally does end up in the scenery.
Well, yes, certainly you have to say, for looking at the championship results, Glenn Owens is really going to be hurt by this round if he fails to finish any of the races, just because he has been quite at the forefront of the championship. He is, in fact, lying second in the championship coming into this round, I think. So, yeah, he has been fighting all the way with its racing. So, yeah, a really big loss for this, or for the Scottish driver in this round. Obviously, yeah. Memso has been charging very hard and is clawing his way up the field and is lying fourth coming into the championship. So, yeah, he's really in a battle for killing Heidi in that third place car, who has now finally been caught by Evil Dragon.
Yes, it seems the battle for the podium is very much warming up, and rather than challenging for second now, you're right, it's Heidi having to defend his third position from Evil Dragon. He's back in the Lexus, isn't he? He was supposed to be running the Mercedes this race after a swap of teams after the demise of his previous teammate Optimus Prime. Unfortunately, last minute he decided to run with what he knew in the form of that Lexus. Seems to be doing him no harm at the moment though, as he is slowly closing in on killing Heidi as this race progresses. Perhaps we're seeing a case once again of the Mercedes not quite looking after its tyres as well as the others, because 17 laps, a lot of stop-start corners around here are slowly going to take the strain on the tyres, especially throwing them over the curbs like that. Things could get interesting here over these final few laps as tyre wear becomes a big factor. What do you think, John? Do you think this championship would it be better or worse, do you think, if we ran these cars on the normal racing soft? Or do you think the mediums have been a beneficial addition to this championship?
Well, I think certainly mediums lend themselves to the character of Australian V8s, don't they? Just because any time you watch those cars, one of them in the pack will be pulling a gratuitously large power slide.
Yes.
So, I think mediums definitely don't hurt the championship at all, and as we see Evil Dragon getting incredibly close to killing Heidi, and if that wasn't contact, then I'll be fairly surprised. But yeah, it certainly does seem that you do get this characteristic that you can overwork the tyres, whereas on softs, generally, they provide pretty decent grip until they're gone. Whereas racing mediums, I've found, you can sort of damage them to the point that they don't provide enough grip if you're too aggressive on them, and yet they still have quite a lot of tyre life in them. So I think it does add a little extra something to the racing.
Completely agree. They are a very delicate and complex tyre, the racing mediums. I say the racing hards and the softs are, to an extent, fairly straightforward, aren't they? There's a fairly linear, you know, drop-off in grip, as you mentioned. But you're right, with the mediums, it is very bizarre if you don't look after them properly. It's almost like a Pirelli Formula One tyre, in the way they can fall to bits if you don't look after them. So it's very similar to that, actually. And Killing Heidi clearly perhaps overworked this for a little bit. You can bring them back a little bit, can't you? But you've got to sort of concentrate a lot, haven't you, to recover a dodgy tyre situation.
Well, yes, and I imagine, especially in cars like these, the difference between sort of abusing the front tyres and understeering and getting the entry speed exactly right is probably less than a mile an hour into a corner. So, yeah, certainly a lot of precision is required, as you had to demonstrate your point. Just look at how far away ITZ Racing is now from Killing Heidi. And remember that Heidi was in fact putting loads and loads of pressure on the Australian driver at the start of the race.
Yeah, so perhaps the Mercedes then was good over qualifying in the first few laps of this race, but has deteriorated now. And the gap at the front looks stable now, we'd say, between Memento and its racing. He doesn't look to have the capacity to close in on Camaro, as we've heard from Memento before. The Camaro is very good at looking after its tyres through the whole race. There's a big slide we saw there from Killing Heidi, demonstrating your point quite nicely there, John. And oh dear, that's not going to do with his situation
like
any good either.
Into the wall and possibly collecting Evil Dragon on the way, but I couldn't honestly tell if the two had contact. Certainly lightning quick reactions from Bush's driver.
Yeah, so unfortunately that's definitely put some damage on Killing Heidi there. It's a shame for the Australian, really, given such a great start to the race he was having after a great qualifying. Santu has gone into the pits, we'd assume, with damage as well. As it's one of the features of this track is the Evil Dragon going off in some sympathy now. They're coming onto the pitch straight. It's a bit unusual to see there. One of the characteristics which we've seen this track is there are walls very close around in places, and it's does seem to be tripping people up at the moment. I suspect people will learn from this for race two and sort it out for then. Someone who looks to have learnt from the word go, though, is Memento 89, who looks to add to his list of victories he took at Brands Hatch, at the Nürburgring, and really bring himself into championship contention here with the demise of Glenn and beating its racing once again. So looks to be a good day at the office for Memento here.
Yes, indeed. He can't really ask for more than this at the start of the race weekend, can he?
No, he's shown a good habit so far of getting the winning habit once he starts, when he dials himself into tracks. We've seen it, as I say, at Brands Hatch, it was quite the opposite of Brands Hatch, at Laguna Nürburgring. When he's happy and content somewhere, he's incredibly difficult to beat. And as we saw at the Nürburgring as well, in his fight with, I believe it was Glenn, when I made comments on his racecraft, and he can be decisive and aggressive when he needs to be, which Glenn lacked at the time, which might have given a bit of scolding for, as I felt he was letting him get away with murder there. No such need on this occasion, though, as we're on the final lap now. Memento, he's been unchallenged, really, from the word go. A bit of company close on, early on, I should say, between its racing and Killing Heidi, but the challenge faded fairly quickly as he stamped his authority over this one. And Killing Heidi, unfortunately, that front row start has turned into fourth place in the race, which is still a good hatful of points for the Australian, but not what he'd have wanted after putting in such great effort in qualifying. But it matters not, though. It's Memento who's going to take the plaudits and the points today, as Memento, I believe, has crossed the line already to take the first win of the day here at Grand Valley East. It's racing, another podium there for the Mustang. As long as he can keep racking those up and limiting the damage, it's good for him. Evil Dragon on the podium, I believe, I may get corrected here, but I think that's his first podium after his heroics. Not say heroics, his dirty deeds going on at the Nürburgring. Santa, unfortunately, still will have to fight his way now through the lapped traffic as the computer takes over at this point, and he's going to have to think on his feet a little bit to finish off this race, although I suspect time will elapse before he gets to the finish line. But not the most exciting race we've ever seen in Australian V8s, unfortunately, but signs look good for race two, do they not, Johnny?
They certainly do, and yes, this battle between Memta and its racing does look well and truly set, doesn't it? I imagine he won't be too happy about having to let the British driver get away from him, so its racing will be desperate to get a good start in race two.
Yeah, we've seen him, his starts are fairly consistent. It'll be interesting to see if we get rejoined by Glenn for race two. So, yeah, not too much to digest there, unfortunately, after that race with Memto winning. But as we've seen before, first races can be a touch procession as everyone's a wee bit cautious. And then all hell can break loose in race two. If you think back to Laguna Seca, where we had that situation, same also with the Nürburgring and other places. Although we are limited by the number of cars on track, it normally doesn't mean for a boring race too. So let's jump into it and see what surprise we've got installed for this one then. Memto, once again on pole position after his win in race one, joined on the front row this time by the Green Mustang of It's Racing. In third position, Evil Dragon, killing Heidi there in fourth position. As the lights have come on once again, who's going to get the jump on it this time? As they go green, more tyre smoke from Memto. But It's Racing doesn't look to get the jump on it back. It's been a great start from Memto. As, in the second phase of it all, It's Racing looks to be challenging. Don't think he's quite got the legs on the Camaro this time around, though. It's as you are, actually, as they go through the first couple of corners. Santu had got in front of killing Heidi very briefly, I think. As we see Santu, he's spun off there, unfortunately. He's got it wide on the exit of turn one whilst battling with killing Heidi, and that has spun the Mercedes around, unfortunately. So Santu's going to have another race at the back, I suspect, as Memto having to defend quite hard now from its racing. The Mustang is not going to let him get away early on this time. He wants to disrupt his rhythm as early as he can here and not let him get away. Evil Dragon wants in on the fun as well, it seems. Killing Heidi not too far behind now that he's dispatched of his Indian adversary. So quite a dramatic first lap already here.
It certainly is, and yes, It's Racing and his determination to get past Memto is almost leaving the door perfectly open to Dragon. So yeah, it's really going to be an intense fight, it looks like, so far. With It's Racing getting the run, and I believe he's got the overspeed now, so he pulled out to the inside. Will he be brave enough on the brakes, or will Memto manage to hold off? It looks as if they're certainly side by side going into turn one and into turn two. But was that a little bit of a nudge from Memto on It's Racing on the outside of turn two?
Oh, unfortunately, didn't see it there. But you're right, it's a fast turn one. You can't always get the job done on the brakes there. You've got to do it into turn two. Well, we saw them running side by side, and it almost cost It's Racing there because it allowed Evil Dragon to get a look down into turn three there. So, as we say, Memto can be firm when he needs to be, as Killing Heidi getting it all out of shape there in his pursuit of Evil Dragon for third place. So, unfortunately, I think that little incident has already given Memto a bit of a gap there in the front, so he might be able to stretch away now, as It's Racing is not going to be picking up too much of a slipstream this time around, unfortunately. So, that may have put the nails in the coffin of this challenge already, but let's not give up hope too yet. We've got Killing Heidi here pursuing Evil Dragon for third place down the pitch straight. As I say, turn one pretty fast on this occasion. You can't really dive down the inside of this one. You've got to be perfectly alongside to claim that first corner. As we see Memto smoke pouring off his tyres, he often sets his cars up like that. It's a feature we've noted throughout his core career in races, particularly in the WEC and the Bentley. We've often noted a vast amount of smoke coming off his car in no time. So Memto, perhaps it's the way he does like it, set up quite stiff. I'll have to ask him one day if it's a feature he deliberately dials in, or if it's just a happy coincidence, really. But for the time being, It's Racing looks to be getting quite out of shape there, and that's dropped him further back from Memto into the clutches of Killing Heidi now.
It certainly has, and although, as you mentioned, turn one doesn't provide any particularly obvious opportunities, there is, as we saw from Memto's driving, the ability to undercut into turn two.
Yes. Oh, here we go. We've got Killing Heidi this time challenging. It's racing down the pitch straight. Mercedes versus Mustang. He's got the tough jobs when I go around the outside of him though here. He looks to be edging ahead. Has he got it turned in? Not quite just yet. It's going to be on the brakes in turn two. He looks to have done it though. Or has he run it too wide there? Oh, he's gone too wide. Is Killing Heidi. That's cost him. That's cost him two places there. It's an Evil Dragon as well, sir. I loved his enthusiasm there, but unfortunately the outside line, oh, and now he's stuck against the wall for good measure as well. Loved the enthusiasm there, unfortunately the execution wasn't good. As now Evil Dragon, he's the one challenging It's Racing here. Evil Dragon's come from nowhere and up to second position now. Fantastic.
Indeed, certainly taking the opportunities that are given to him. As yet, it seems like It's Racing may have just tapped Heidi's car there, just destabilising it slightly, as we said, through that very heavily loaded double left-hander. But yeah. It's Racing right back on it again, taking the inside line, forcing Dragon wide, and he does appear to have taken the advantage onto the home straight.
Yeah, he'd frightened Evil Dragon off the apex there, but he's still maintained good speed around the outside of the Evil Dragon, and it's still making It's Racing work for it. Is he going to make him go the long way around this time round? I think, no, he's given him the inside lines. Fair play to Dragon there, could have made him work harder for it. As he's now trying to hang it around the outside, we've seen how well this has worked out so far. Unfortunately, it doesn't end too well for people. He's still side by side with him, though. He's not giving it up, and now he's going to give him the inside into turn three, and he's taking it back, and it's Racing who's hit the wall instead. What is going on this time round? All these moves people are trying to make around the outside, they're not making them stick, and it's costing him quite dearly. This time round, it was he who was on the inside who's ended up in the wall. So, this is...
As we saw then, certainly it does seem that running the outside line in turn one to then get the cutback onto the inside of turn two does give you that momentum advantage. And certainly it just looked like then that It's Racing just overloaded the tyres through those two left-handers, just didn't have any grip coming into turn four.
Killing Heidi, no grip from the rear tyres there, trying to put power down coming onto the pitch straight. Well, my hypothesis was correct. Race one may be a bit of a slow burner, but race two, people really get stuck into it. Memento, though, with a rather commanding lead this time round as everyone else is fighting. Oh, is he spinning? Is he going to spin off there? That was a huge slide from Memento there. I feared for a moment he was going to pitch that into the wall, but no, he's hung on to it there. Good job, Memento. And he'll carry on his way there as everyone else will continue to scrap behind him. So he obviously wants to build a bit of a cushion to give himself time to play with later on, but for now he's playing a bit of a dangerous game, but no one else is around to play with him. Santu, no one else to play with him, unfortunately, as he's mired at the back once again, unfortunately. So the mid-season promise we're starting to see from Santu has not transferred itself to this racetrack. It could just be a circuit-dependent thing, perhaps. Santu not overly fond of this track, as I say. It is a bit hit and miss on people, this place, so perhaps not Santu's favourite place. It's Racing now. He's got himself a bit of work to do. If he wants to limit the damage in this race, at the moment he's going to lose a lot of points to Memento if he finishes in this fourth place.
Well, it's also important to remember that Santu is in a brand new car for this race, having transferred to Team AIM. So, he joins Killing Heidi and indeed Evil Dragon, but Dragon having decided to stick with the car that he'd been driving so far all season. Whereas Santu trying something new, so that's possibly where these teething issues are coming from.
Ah, yes, that would explain it. And speaking of the new teammates, there they are batting away for second place now. It's allowing Its Racing to close back up just a little bit, as we've seen already how feisty things can get in this race. And the no overtaking around this track is being disproved, although it's more due to people running off track at the moment. But let's not pick faults with it at the moment. Let's enjoy the racing we've got going on, and a battle for second heating up quite nicely now.
Yes, indeed. And one person who is definitely enjoying this racing is Memento, since it is just giving him the opportunity to drive away into the distance, as we see there his car just a speck on the horizon. As, yes, the battle for second is really heating up. Ooh, as Memento runs very wide and has just clipped the wall. So,
oh,
this...
dear.
It as does
we were
appear
just
that...
singing his praises, it has gone and bitten him. Ooh.
Yes, the commentator's curse clearly works even in the past.
It was looking too good. He'd built it for near... It looks to be gone the order of 6 or 7 seconds by that point, and now... It's all gone away from him. He's still there or thereabouts though. There's time for Memso to rectify this problem, as we know the Camaro hangs onto its tyres quite nicely in this race, so we've certainly got a fight in our hand now as Evil Dragon takes up the lead in this one, killing Heidi now to fend off its racing for that second position. But Memso, who I'm sure will be rather angry at this stage, looks to get back. Oh, he's already on the back of the Mustang. Wasting no time here is Memso in getting his leads back. It'll be interesting to see if he's got any damage from that one. I suspect, given the nature, these cars are quite tough. No damage, we're being told. So it's going to be one angry little Memso behind that wheel looking to get. Oh, as we see, oh. Evil Dragon spinning off. As it, no, he's held on to it. Just a big Larry slide in the end. But it's allowed its racing to nip past killing Heidi. It's slowed down the Australian there. Allowed the other Australian past.
It did look like there was a bit of contact there, and certainly I think that possibly Heidi did in fact tag Evil Dragon then, which did slow down the Mercedes quite a lot. But yeah, certainly no love lost between those teammates, as Heidi's car gets very Larry and lightning quick reactions from Memso to get round the back of that car.
It's still from Memso, we see him spinning off there, yeah, killing Heidi's challenge looks to have been dented as he now drops well behind. So now it is a fight between just the top three for the lead of this one. Memso, can he recover his lead in this one? It's looking likely, isn't it? Evil Dragon doing a good job in front, though. It's racing now. We'll smell an opportunity. He does not want to lose any more points to Memso if he can help it. But we've seen how quick the Camaro is today. So we're in for a barnstorming final. 7 laps of this race. Killing Heidi now. I suspect his only thing to do now be consolidated. We're seeing it now. It is people putting perhaps a single wheel on those curves, the flat ones. Maybe they're quite deceptive, these curves, as they appear to be what's spitting people off a few times, or at least getting people sideways, and then it's catching people out, really. So maybe people need to think a little bit more. Yes, here, those ones there, you can see it once again, they're getting a little bit sideways there. So perhaps these guys should think a bit more about us. But oh, that's definitely running wide there. It's racing. Put a wheel on the grass, it's slowing dramatically. What's it going to give Memso an opportunity into the final corner? Is Memso going to hang it around the outside? It looks like he's trying it. It's racing, he's giving him the space, he's not pushing him wide, and Memso has just glided around the outside. Great stuff there from the cherry red Camaro.
Yes indeed, and certainly, as you said, give race drivers any form of paved area and they will try and run it to the very edge of the gravel, but certainly it does seem that it's actually not the quickest way around these corners. And it does make you wonder though if Memso is pushing too hard, and as we've seen in the first race, whether his tyres will manage to hang on as a big slide from Evil Dragon, I think possibly assisted by Memso slightly there, sees the Lexus lose out to that red Camaro.
Yes, but Memso got such a drive off turn two there, just completely outdrove the Lexus there. I don't think Evil Dragon would have been suspecting that, and yeah, there may have been light contact between the two. Either way, I suspected it would have taken Memso 7 laps to regain lead. It's taken him, in fact, just 1 from my original hypothesis. So good stuff there from Memso. Let's watch him lose it again, though. So
yes, there's always time. Let's not say it's all over yet.
This isn't over yet, not by a long shot. We've seen the top three close, not the top three, but we've seen groups of three close throughout this entire race so far. And now it is for the lead. I think Memso may be a bit more circumspect this time round. He's not going to try and do anything stupid to lose it once again. It's Dragon versus Evil Racing here, the new members of Core. It's racing into the wall once again. He's definitely got some rear damage this time on that Mustang, and that will make things quite lively for the Australian there. That might have dented. I'm using words here. Dented his challenge to challenge the lead on this occasion. Evil Dragon looks to be pulling away now, as is Memso actually, but dust being kicked up there. We don't see a Camaro in the scenery though, so he's held on to it. Clearly still pushing on quite hard though, is Memso.
Yes, you would have thought from his previous instances he may be trying to restrain himself slightly more and just hold that gap, since it seems pretty obvious Evil Dragon just doesn't have the pace to contest with or really sort of challenge him for the lead. So he is really his biggest enemy at the moment, as certainly it's racing doing a good job of chasing down Dragon even with that damage, as we hear in fact that Evil Dragon has damage as well, so that could well explain it.
Yes, it's the battle of the damage then for second position. We think Memso is unscathed at the moment, but we'll wait to hear reports on that. Yeah, we're hearing from the pits. Memso is fine at the moment, so he's got a bit of a Napoleon complex going on the lead. He wants to humiliate everyone, doesn't want to just beat them on this occasion. As we see again, more smoke, more dust being kicked up. He's using every bit of racetrack. Yeah, they like kicking that little bit of dust there. Oh God, a good illustration there of the damage Evil Dragon's got. Must be rear end damage there. Oh, he's sliding all over the place now. How is he keeping up this kind of pace with damage this bad? He's sliding all over the place at the moment. This is not going to do his tyres any good with the remaining four laps of this race at the moment.
Absolutely, these two really are going to struggle to make it to the end. Having said that, they do have a very large gap back to Santu, who has in fact got past killing Heidi that we'd missed previously, but clearly neither of those drivers having the best race that they could at the moment, as it's racing getting very wide just on the edge of the grass there, certainly all over the back of Evil Dragon's car, so I imagine the fireworks are about to go off.
Yeah, the amount of this is turning into a drift race at the moment, the amount of sideways action we're seeing going on here. Memso in the lead, Evil Dragon smoking in sympathy, it's racing, pushing and nudging as much as he can here to try and unhinge Evil Dragon from that second place. He's clearly a bit wary as that Lexus is slightly out of control at times. So he's only going to stick his nose up the inside and then have it promptly bitten off by that rather ferocious dragon of second place there. And you're right, killing Heidi. Now falling down to last place. So things have gone even worse for him in this one. Santu up to fourth place, but you're right, there's a big gap between third and fourth, so these guys have got a bit of room to play with and still come away from this one with a podium. But as we mentioned, it's racing, would not want to lose more points than necessary to Memso once again. There is still three laps to go though, so anything can still happen after the way this race has gone. And yeah, this has brilliantly followed the format of Aussie V8, as I mentioned so far. Race one can be a bit stale, but race two and three often make up for it, and this one has made up for it in spades. We've seen all the normal gung-ho heroics we love in this series, sideways action, bit of bumping and barging, people making mistakes in these tricky to drive rear drive powerful V8 motor cars. And Memso looks to have got a firm handle on things at the moment, but we were saying that earlier and then we saw how that turned out. So as I say, counting our chickens not yet, as it's racing, crawling all over the back of Evil Dragon once again. Looks to have run on him this time though.
It did almost seem like the Ford was pushing the Lexus along the start finish straight there, and that's how close they were, but somehow the Japanese car has just managed to keep ahead of that Mustang, though how long it's racing has managed to get the undercut into turn two. So just the tyres getting the best of him, and yeah, Evil Dragon just running slightly too wide.
Yeah, we see it once again, the heroics of people hanging around the outside of turn one, giving them a vague glimmer of hope of hanging on to a position to turn two, but it's turn two that then turns into our undoing, as there is a bit of gravel to be pushed wide on and lose the momentum, as we saw it's racing do there as he pushed Evil Dragon wide a wee little bit there. Interesting, it's Killing Heidi who's got the fastest lap of the race at the moment. I suspect having pitted for fresh tyres, which has helped him out. Memso, according to the gap, he is... it's over Santu. Yeah, so Santu about half a minute off the lead at the moment, which in fact isn't enough of a gap for the others to make a pit stop and retain a third place if necessary. So they've got a bit of work to do still. They have to be somewhat careful not to sustain too much damage in this one.
Having said that, with how close the battle is for second, I doubt either it's racing or Evil Dragon are even considering a pit stop at this moment in time. So yeah, I have a feeling that all of the leaders are determined to make it to the end no matter what happens.
I suspect you are right on that one, as this is the final lap in all the excitement, as we see Killing Heidi closing in slightly on Santu. It'll be interesting to see if he can do anything on the final lap. But once again, Memso, as he rounds the final corner, he may have made a mistake, but he's snatched back straight away to reclaim the lead, showing the ferocity he's renowned for once again. to make it 2-2 so far here in Grand Valley as Memto wins race number 2 here at Grand Valley's It's Racing. Looks to have a good handle on second place. He does. Second place once again for It's Racing. Evil Dragon on the podium once again after a fantastic battle all the way through. Led at one stage. Looked to have legitimate battles with people this time round, which we like to see. Santu coming through for fourth position, killing Heidi in fifth, unfortunately. As we say, Glenn unable to race this time, going to lose even more points out. So, Memto really on the charge at the moment.
Yes, it certainly has been a very good race for him. That Camaro looks absolutely dialed into this circuit. And yeah, the two of them just seem completely unrivaled this round.
They do, yeah, as we... Well, what action have we got in race 3 then? This should be quite the interesting spectacle. We've got the same grid, or the same top 3 we had from race number 2. So, what have people learnt this time round? What have they sussed out at the start? Have they spotted a weakness yet in Memto? We saw It's Racing challenge all the way through that first lap last time, where they isolated the fact that you've got to hit him early on, otherwise he'll get ahead. But then we saw how that all went on. So perhaps we're just talking rubbish here. Let's jump to the action then and see what goes on this time. John, would you like to take us away this time?
Sure, why not? And yes, it certainly does seem that the drivers are starting to learn the ins and outs of this circuit, and maybe we'll see them being intelligent on the curbs, but let's not hold our breath for that one.
Yeah,
as we see the lights starting to come on the gantry, 3, 4, 5, and they're out. Memto getting a fantastic start once again, but it looks like ITZ may have bogged down slightly with Evil Dragon possibly getting the run on him, but no, it seems that it's his consolidated position with Santu and Heidi leading up the rear. So it does appear as if they are just heading off in nice processional order.
Yes, I don't think I've ever seen an exact line astern of five cars going into the first corner before. Not one person was having a look down the inside of someone else. That was rather bizarre by course standards. Normally everyone's all over the place looking for an opportunity. It's racing. Very sideways there. Someone who's sideways again is Santu in last place, wasn't it? Unfortunately, same pattern once again happening for Santu. Clearly not gelling with that car yet or with the circuit. Or both, but no, it's as we are really at the moment, isn't it? I think maybe all the action's been exhausted in race 2. At the moment, It's Racing trying to latch onto the back of Memto early on. He's trying to repeat his actions from race number 2. I don't think he's got a long run straight here and a good enough slipstream to challenge him into turn 1. Maybe he can close up the race. He is gaining here. What can he do into turn 2 at the moment? Is a smoky Camaro. Maybe off-putting to him there, but no opportunity this time round. So what do you think his strategy is going to be this time round then, John?
It really depends, just because we've seen that Memto can make mistakes. So if he's picked up on that, then hopefully he's just going to keep his notes nice and clean. Don't make mistakes, don't use the tyres too much, because as you see, Memto is pushing really hard at the moment, missing quite a few apexes early in the lap. So maybe he is just trying to get the British drivers to just wear out his tyres more than he does, and then take the opportunity later in the race, as Memto again running very wide into the final corner with It's Racing nice and tidy on that apex.
Yeah, that was good stuff there from It's Racing. He scared Memto off the apex enough there to compromise his drive off the final corner, and this could be what It's Racing has been looking for. He's drawing alongside into turn 1. How's he going to get it on the brake this time? Is Memto going to hang it around the outside? It looks as if It's Racing's not left him any room this time round. We don't see a cherry red Camaro alongside him because it's behind him. Good stuff there from It's Racing. He's finally got that one sorted. Been practicing it for 2 races and now he's delivered. But as we've seen before, the Camaro does hold onto its tyres better, so we don't think Memto's gone just yet, and he has been faster than in all rates so far, so it's unlikely to see the Mustang pull away this time round. But who knows, we could be surprised. But well, certainly that Camaro leeching onto the back of that Mustang at the moment. So yeah, I really don't think this is over just yet. In fact, it's as if it's being pushed along here. In fact, he's having a look already back into the last corner. Yep, up the inside goes the Mustang. Not the Mustang, the Camaro. Well, that didn't last very long, did it?
No, not at all. certain you can see Mento's confidence in the car that he's not even waiting for the back straight to just get back past. He's that confident in his car's ability to just pull away from that Mustang down the back straight. And it has another go up the inside, and Mento giving him space, but I don't think the Mustang has done it. Very, very considerate racing by both those drivers there, with Mento not pinching the apex when he could have, and indeed it's just holding off from pushing Mento wide. So yeah, nicely done, guys.
Yeah, so a lot of room being left there by Mento. Very unusual for him. He's normally the one punishing people for doing that sort of thing. So perhaps he's enjoying it. Perhaps he's toying with the Mustang a little bit. We have heard him say the Camaro, whilst it's good on its tyres, the downside to that is that it struggles to heat them up quite effectively as the Mustang does. But just to illustrate, I thought we'd run it all the way around the outside of the Mustang once again there. Didn't quite put it off though, he has got a good exit and looks to be lining up the Mustang now for turn number one. Camaro, sometimes we've seen struggle in a straight line, and he's unable to blast past the Mustang, and he's been forced to go around the outside and can't quite make it this time around, so nothing going on for him this time around. But this has allowed Evil Dragon to come onto the back of him now, and they'll want to be careful here of what Alexis could do. We may see him get excited once again and make a rash move, but as we see Mento, he's compromised himself on the curbs there and is giving Evil Dragon a look around the outside here as they go through turn number four. What's it going to do for Evil Dragon? He's shoving the Camaro wide there, but he's not made it work from this time round. But good feisty stuff from Evil Dragon there.
Yeah, he's possibly a little bit too polite coming through that left hander, just because he could have very easily slammed the door on Mento then and taken the second apex then for himself. But yeah, nice considerate racing. So Mento has managed to retain his second place, but the leaders definitely all fight together there, with Heidi lingering in the distance just in case they make a mistake.
Yeah, he's slowly drawing himself back into contention after a bit of a horrible first couple of races after that great qualifying at the start. And we could see if he can finally get a good result from this race. He'd deserve it for efforts alone would killing Heidi. Unfortunately, Santu not going to be partaking in this one on this occasion, although he's not as far back as we've seen him before. He's still sort of in play if something goes on with one of these lot. And when things are this close in Aussie V8, something does happen. So I suspect fireworks will go off any moment soon, as once again Mento looks to be lining up his favourite overtake into the last corner. Looks to have a good run through as fast sweepers over the top of the hill there.
He certainly does.
Oh, there's contact there though.
I almost thought It's Racing had gotten wise then and was using his car nice and cleverly to go and block Mento's move to the outside, but Push Driver still managing to pull it off with just a little tap between the two cars. It looks like Evil Dragon has got the run absolutely on Mento's car, so will the Camaro manage to run it down the outside, or will he get pushed off? I can't even judge it at this moment in time. No, he's held on. Wow, good stuff.
Yeah, normally we've seen so far, people run it around the outside of turn two. It can end badly for the Mento. Hold on to that time though. Evil Dragon didn't shove him wide as he could have done. Oh, Killing Heidi looks to have sustained some damage there and put it into the wall. So that's his challenge dented, unfortunately. A pity there, as we were hoping something good could come to him in this race. But it's the same top three once again as bit of rally crossing from Evil Dragon there. He's turned up to the wrong race if he was looking for that. There's a different time of year for that. Mento, his favourite move once again though. Being quite forceful into that last corner now. He's clearly showing It's Racing that he can overtake wherever and whenever, really, if he really wanted to. The Mustang's got the grunt down the straight though to pose a threat into turn one, as we've seen already. Doesn't look close enough this time though, but rather bipolar racing here from Mento. Sometimes quite aggressive and then almost too gentle at the times.
That's another huge slide from him there. And yeah, certainly it does seem as though Mento can just really push past It's Racing whenever. And it was definitely interesting to see when we had Mento really sort of fighting with Evil Dragon, that It's Racing, unlike in the previous two races where we've seen the battle for second really heat up and Mento just managed to pull away, It's Racing just unable to get away from those two chasing cars. So clearly the Ford just not happy on this track.
Yeah, I suspect maybe Memso remembers the Nürburgring where he had a bit of trouble with Evil Dragon and Optimus Prime on that occasion, so he's giving that Lexus a wider berth than he normally would do in case of an incident, and perhaps he knows he can get away with that sort of racing with its racing, so I think maybe that's what we're seeing going on here. Either way, he's got the lead at the moment. The Mustang has not dropped off as of yet though, and as Memso's run it wide though, he's given the Mustang a chance here as he's trying to hold it around the outside of turn two. He's done it. Amazingly, I'm staggered he held onto that one. That's fantastic stuff from Memso there, and well, that could have ended very badly for him. Instead, he's managed to recover the situation quite nicely. Good stuff there.
Yeah, I think that was its racing being incredibly kind to Memso there, just because I have a feeling he could have just run to the outside of that corner and no one would have batted an eye, really, as far as race craft goes. But no, he nice and carefully held off and allowed Memso that tiniest little sliver. And yeah, that perfect Camaro-sized space, and Memso went for it and made it.
Yeah, you don't need to invite him twice into a gap, do you need to remember? Oh, more dust being kicked up there from Evil Dragon. He really wants to show up for the rallycross season if he's keeping this up, and there'll be no more grass left at Grand Valley at the end of this one. He'll be on for his third consecutive podium of the day, though, will Evil Dragon, if he hangs on to this, which would, I know we've got limited running and perhaps haven't quite got the calibre we're normally used to with MCLA not being here. Obviously Glenn dropped out early on. GP Bambi we haven't seen for a while, but we know obviously he can be good when he's here. So let's take it away from Evil Dragon though. He's been very good in consistency when the likes of Killing Heidi and Santu have more often not made several mistakes. Killing Heidi in particular, unfortunately, nearly a lap behind now after his earlier contact and making a necessary pit stop, it seems, to do away with that damage. So we'll be looking to just avoid going a lap down in this one. Once again though, fastest lap from him, taking advantage of his fresh tyres, which always a useful commodity even such a short sprint race as this and on the racing mediums. So Memso looks to he's not quite shaking off its racing just yet, so this is interesting. While we haven't seen the Mustang hold on to this sort of pace in the previous two races, but it's good to see it. Maybe they've found something for race three, although I think they're very limited to what they can change into the final race, if they can actually change anything at all. So maybe it's in his head he's found something there. Have you ever found that, John, a mental change going into another race has altered the car rather unexpectedly as opposed to an actual physical setup?
Well, there's that, but yeah, even sort of between stints though, you can find that you can be driving a car that you're absolutely struggling. Ooh, as we see Santu having it off there, but still enough of an advantage, I think, to manage to retain fourth place, and I don't think he hit the barrier hard enough to give himself damage. But yeah, going back to the point, I certainly think that you can be driving a car that you're absolutely not getting on with, that's just oversteering and understeering whenever you don't want it to. And then you can come into the pits, just sort of have that 5 minute rest, and then suddenly everything works again. And yes, you get fresh tyres, but it can last over the course of the stint, that suddenly that tiny sort of difference in your technique can make all the difference, and it's just that you sort of have got too wound up to really let it go.
Yeah, it's it's similar to before the N24 this year, when I was piloting the Audi in the VLN, and as you will remember from my rather persistent bitching of my dislike towards that car, and then I found I think about an hour into the race that a change of approach to it suddenly found about 4 or 5 seconds mid-race, which was a happy coincidence. Still miles off the pace, but you know, it was better than being lots of miles off the pace. So good
well,
stuff.
Well, yes,
there.
As Evil Dragon is proving that you don't actually need to be the fastest driver out there at all to get to the end. It's just you need to be comfortable in your car, and certainly he is proving that over Santu, for example, in that brand new Mercedes of his, that possibly having stuck with the Lexus would have been the way to go for this round. But yes, mentioning our N24 Challenge, it has reminded me that, yes, despite the fact that Concrete Climax Racing has been running for the best part of 3 years now, I think.
3 years, yeah.
That, yeah, we've never actually raced on the same team. It's in... You contested the 2014 Nürburgring 24 Hours when I was absent.
Yes, then, this is true. I
contested Le Mans and the 2015 race without you.
Our team was done a disservice by both not being there on those occasions, but more of that for another time. Back to the, I would say, action. Unfortunately, it is somewhat diluted at this stage, as Memso has now very slowly started to creep ahead, as per usual, from the Mustang. We've seen mistakes, though, so perhaps the... there's one for you right there. Evil Dragon running it wide. Holds on to it though, doesn't spin off and put it into the wall. Good stuff once again. That's what we've seen from Evil Dragon today. He may get it sideways and a bit leery on occasions, but he catches it. He's not actually chucked it majorly at the wall yet, so perhaps
a bit of showboating. Very well, reeling himself in, doesn't he, and not sort of just getting too obsessed with catching the cars ahead.
Very much comfortable in his own skin. Clearly he just wants to bag some good points in this race, which he will do for a third consecutive third place. Not as good as Memso though, for a third consecutive win, and it's racing, don't think you can do much better damage limitation in three consecutive seconds when the fastest guy's going to win all of them, so good stuff in this one. We're hearing that Evil had a bit of mentoring, let's say, from Memso before his race on the setting car, because that's one thing Memso has always been good at. He's been very good at setting up a car, regardless of what type it is. Oh, it's killing Heidi. Has clouted the wall once again, unfortunately, and is facing the wrong way in the tunnel on this occasion. Let's hope he doesn't hit anyone. No, they've all gone through now, so he can turn it around in a safe manner. And, dear, from a stellar qualifying job, it's all gone from bad to worse, unfortunately, for Killing Heidi on race day. And, he'll want to go away and have a look at his performance in this one. Perhaps it's someone who could do with a bit of setup help there himself to come upstairs. Or perhaps it's, it could just be a Mercedes issue that they're not quite on top of, but it's tyre situation. This is definitely a man on top of his tyres, though, as they go into the penultimate lap. It's racing not too far away. It's about a second and a half behind at this stage, maybe even less than that, actually. So, it's been a good job from its racing. Not quite as good as it could have been, though. And, it's an end of battleship smoke pouring off that Camaro. Oh, as it's racing, just as we praised him, though, he's gone and spun off. Don't think he's hit the wall, though, on this occasion. He doesn't look so many damage, and he's managed to turn it around the right way and got going before Evil Dragons had a chance to pounce. He'll have seen that, though. He's going to see it's racing up ahead. And know he's going to be compromised on his tyres at the moment, as they're dirty and cold. So Evil Dragon will want to pounce it, see if he can get an extra position away from this race, if he can take that second place. It's racing here on the back foot, it seemed. And, as we thought, going from challenging potential lead to fend off second place. This shows that you never can turn your back on this race. It's action all the way, isn't it?
Oh yes, certainly. It's used most frequently in endurance racing, so that in order to finish first you must finish. It certainly proves that even in a 20-minute sprint, you really do need to be absolutely on top of your driving and drive within yourself to avoid making these mistakes, just because, as you said, suddenly its racing has gone from challenging the top step to challenging the last step of the podium.
Well, it's been hectic stuff here. Evil Dragon is on the last lap now. He can afford to take a bit of a risk at this stage to try and go for second. He's got nothing to lose to an extent. We've lost Santu from this one now. We haven't seen what. I suspect it may be a connection related issue, as those do unfortunately dog the engine quite often. So disconnection, we're being told. Is Evil Dragon going to have a slid up the inside into last corner? He's side by side, it looks like he's going for it. He has got on the brakes as well. Good stuff from Evil Dragon there. But it's racing going for the undercut. He's going to have a long straight now. Oh, it's racing. He's taking advantage of Evil Dragon, sliding it wide there, unfortunately. He did go for it though, Evil Dragon. Got to commend him for trying. Memso though has taken victory, and a rather smoky end to the race there from its racing, who's done a handbrake turn across the line. Not sure Evil Dragon would have appreciated that filling his screen, but it's Memsodo who's going to take maximum points from this event, which is fantastic. I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that's the first time I've seen someone take victory at every single race so far this season, which is a good coup from Memsodo. Oh no, sorry, of course, we had that's a Brands Hatch for MCLA, or it's racing on that occasion. So long ago now, I forgot. Yeah, it was it's racing who took the coup on that occasion. So ignore me, I clearly don't know what I'm talking about. But good stuff for Memsodo. I believe this will be his, I'm sure I'll get correct on this one as well, though. Seventh win of the season, I believe. Possibly his eighth. Either way, he's good at racking those wins up, though. Killing Heidi, unfortunately, still. I think he's on his last lap, given how fast he appears to be going on this one. So I think he was lapped. Yeah, he was lapped in the end of it, wasn't he? Of course, so we saw him spin off and hit the wall, unfortunately. So not a good way to end his day here at Grand Valleys. But perhaps he'll go away, reevaluate his setup, and come back stronger at the next round. But anyway, well, interesting race we've had here today, John. So what have you made it of all? I appear to have lost my colleague. No, I'm not sure. Fill a gap for Memsodo then taking away maximum points in this one. And my coup for. Actually, no, I'm going to give Driver of the Day to Evil Dragon for consistency. I've got one little hiccup we saw him make. So, yeah, Evil Dragon, my Driver of the Day on this one for his three third places. Although you'd be hard pressed to argue against Memso what with three wins doing his championship. A whole load of good in that one. It's racing, almost snatching defeat from the jaws of, well, not victory, from mediocrity at the end there, unfortunately. Oh, excuse me. 3 second places aren't going to do him too much harm at all. What with Glenn not scoring at all in any race, which is yeah, obviously not good at all for his prospects. But yeah, as we're running out of time in this season, Memso has become a real championship threat now, which is livening it up. Hopefully going to turn it into a three-way fight then between It's Racing, Glenn and Memso. But, well, we'll have to wait until the next round to see what excitement we've got in store for us in this rather brilliant inaugural Aussie V8 series. Well, as per usual, I've been Tom Shawley. This has been Johnny B. And we'll see you all guys. Oh, no, Johnny lives. Any final thoughts for us there, Johnny?
Well, certainly it was a very intense... three sets of races, wasn't it? And yeah, despite this performance in the first two, Memso not having it all his way and really being made to fight for those race wins, although as we saw, ITZ just unable to really keep up the fight in that Ford. So yes, rumour has it that for Tokyo he will be in something else, but as to what that is, we don't know.
Yeah, we'll look forward to how that one develops, and if he is going to be in something different, I say Tokyo, the next race, always a popular favourite amongst people. One of my personal favourites, actually. Have you always, you're a fan of it there, John?
Oh, absolutely. I think it's a brilliant track. And yeah, despite, as we've discussed, possibly a lot of features that don't actually lend themselves to racing particularly, it certainly does have those two very tight corners at the start and end of that long, long straight, though, that could well provide a lot of opportunities for overtaking.
There is, and lots of walls as well lining the street course, so as per usual, chances for people to bin it, as we've seen today, in a slightly more forgiving environment. We look forward to that one then. That should be quite a thriller. As I say, we've only got two races to go after this one, Tokyo being one of them, and then the final round should be quite good, as we'll hopefully have multiple drivers still in contention at that stage. We'll hopefully bring you a complete points roundup before then, though, to give you all the maths, as I'm sure people will be interested to work out as we go along who's still in contention here. But until then, we bid you all goodbye. I've been Tom Shawley again, joined by Johnny, and until Tokyo, we bid you all goodbye.